if you take this basic equation and assuming constant growth rate and constant required rate of return, this is a return that the investor expects by investing in the stock market. Now, what is the return that the investor expects by investing in the Pakistani stock market? If you look at the performance of the Pakistani stock market, it has given about an 18% per year return over the last 30 years. So that's the return that an investor expects when he invests in the stock market. What is the return that the investor expects when he invests in like a bank or in, let's say, PIBs, which are sort of low risk or risk-free? About 10%. So what is the premium, extra premium, risk premium when somebody invests in the stock market? It's about 8%. The difference between 10%, which is on a risk-free asset, and 18%, which is the return that the investor has earned over a longer period in the stock market. So basically, this equation says that the return that the investor expects consists of the risk-free rate, which I said is 10% historically. Now, obviously, it has gone up to 12%, if you look at, or 13%. If you look at the 10-year PIB rate today, it's about 13%. But historically, over a longer period, it has been about 10%. And the return, the risk premium, KA minus KRF, is the risk premium, which is the difference between the return on the stock market and the risk-free rate. This is about 8%. Okay. So the price of the share depends on the dividends that the company is going to pay, and divided by the required rate of return of the investor minus the growth rate in earnings of that company. This is a very, you know, sort of small model that explains how a company is valued, or how the stock market is valued. Now, the same can be, I have put down the same equation here, but what are the basic relationships we see from this? That the price of the share, as the dividends grow of a company, the price of the share goes up. As the risk-free rate goes up, the price of the share goes down. Why does the risk-free rate go up? Generally, the risk-free rate basically is based on inflation. And as inflation goes, as we have seen in the last 2 years, if you look at the 10-year PIB, it was yielding 10%, now it's yielding 13%. Okay, so the risk-free rate basically goes up. It is bad news for the stock market, because that generally means inflation going up. The risk premium goes up, as it has over the last couple of years with the bomb blast and about all that, we see the stock market going down. And as the corporate earnings grow, we see the stock market going up. So these are the basic relationships that we should keep in mind, when we are looking at not only the stock market, but obviously any investment, because this model applies to any investment that you would make. It could be a real estate investment, it could be the stock market investment, and so on. Finally, basically, just at the price-earning ratio of the stock market, if you try to find out the price-earning ratio using the same equation from last slide, this comes, all we have done here is divided P by E, and E is the earnings per share or total earnings of the market, and here also dividing it by E to make it equal. Now, so this tells us what is the intrinsic price-earning ratio or valuation of the Pakistani stock market. Now, if we look at some of the variables today, if you look at the dividend payout ratio, right now it's about 54% on the stock market. So if a company earns 100, it pays out 54 rupees in dividend, keeps the rest for growth. If you look at the risk-free rate, 10-year PIB rate, it's about 12.8% at present. If you look at the equity risk premium, it has historically been 8%. We are using a little bit higher rate, 8.5% for now. Inflation, around 10% over the long term. Real GDP growth rate, IMF forecast, is 5% going forward the next 5 years, 10 years. And so if you look at the corporate earnings growth rate, it is basically the sum of inflation and real GDP growth. So we expect the corporate earnings growth rate to be 15% in Pakistan going forward. If we take all these numbers and put back in that equation you show on the last slide, now if you go to the next slide, we see that the intrinsic price earning ratio of the Pakistani stock market right now is about 8.6 times. This is where the market should be valued. The estimate price to earning ratio based on fiscal year 11 earnings is 7.3 times. So it looks like this, it looks as if the stock market is about 18% undervalued. Okay, and we expect that over time, this should return in the stock market going up. You saw obviously a huge crash. The market has started going up, but it's not gone back to the previous levels. So based on even today's indicators, which are not very positive, where PIB rate is about 13%, the stock market still seems a little bit undervalued. If you look at the same price to earning ratio, which is 7.3 in Pakistan, for India it's about 16 or 18 times. For China, it's I think more close to 20 times. So yes, there are economic risks, there are political risks, there is a law and order situation, but most of that is already reflected in the stock market prices. You know, again, if you look at the historical price earning ratio on the Pakistani market, it has been about 10 times. Presently, it's about 7.3. Again, telling us that the market is a little bit cheaper than where it should be. I think that sort of sums up my presentation. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Mr. Amjad Wahid, the CEO, NAFA Funds. Ladies and gentlemen, as we all know, a common man in Pakistan has just known the banks and the national savings institutions only to invest in Pakistan before the launch of mutual funds. Mutual funds completely changes the trend of investment not only for individuals but for the corporate sector as well. Arif Habib Investment is among the pioneers of mutual funds industry in Pakistan. Today, we are lucky enough to have with us the Chief Executive Officer of Arif Habib Investment. He has served as a Deputy Chief Executive of National Investment Trust Limited as well. He was a key member of the professional team that successfully turned around the NIT during the difficult periods. In 2003, he was a part of the task force set up by the Securities and Exchange Commission of Pakistan to develop voluntary pension schemes. He's a fellow chartered accountant from the Institute of Chartered Accountants of Pakistan. Ladies and gentlemen, I request you all to please welcome the Chief Executive Officer of Arif Habib Investment.
Fellow speakers, ladies and gentlemen, Assalamu alaikum. Since we are running late, I'll quickly get into the topic I'm here for. Really, the idea is that, yes, we're looking at investment opportunities in Pakistan, but for the average person in this room, the opportunities come through investing in financial instruments of sorts, and that is what I will be focusing upon. I am the